you end up feeling like you got your first break, really, within the industry?
When I did water, really. But it was like, I had already been having a buzz in the city, and people been knowing about me, but when I did water, it was like, boom, it just expanded. Bigger people, you feel me? Yeah. Bigger brands.
Yeah, so how did you get water to get that big? What was the situation to where that single was on, like, every urban radio station in the U.S.?
Man, it was crazy because at first we were doing our own thing, but my manager then was locked up. My manager then was locked up when I dropped this song.
Wait a minute. Your management was...
Yeah, they was locked up when I dropped this song. My baby mom was locked up around the time, so I had all the kids, you feel me, around the time. So I just leaked the song. I'm like, man, fuck, I'm going to leak it because everybody kept telling me, man, this the one. And I got tired of hearing folks saying that. Cause I'm like, man, that ain't nothing. I go way harder than that. But boom, when I leaked it, I hit up this dude named Wild Out. I was like, do you know how to drop songs on YouTube? And he was like, yeah, because I didn't know how to do it. I had just recently got out. Had been out probably like 6 months or 7 months, 8 months or something like that. But I was like, I don't know how to do it, bro. So I sent the song to him, sent the artwork to him, and he loaded it up for me. So I didn't pay it no mind. Like, I used to go on there and just check the views. I did it for like the first couple of days. Then I ain't go back on there and pay it no mind. I started seeing everybody on Instagram reposting it. Like, and I started reposting their videos back to back. So it just made everybody want to, like, feel like they're a part of something. You know how it is. So everybody started making videos. Boom, boom, boom. Send them to me. I said, fuck it, I'm finna tell everybody to make videos and send them. Started posting everybody video. It just started moving. Then by the time my manager done got out, the song had already grew legs. So all I needed then was the radio and the fund behind it. You feel me? So once they got out and put the fund behind it, we just went up from there. Cause I think when we first dropped it, we dropped a 10. Then we dropped a 20. K-Mac dropped a 20 on it for radio. Like, we spent our own money. Did before the label got involved.
Man.
Warner kind of got involved when the song was like here and it was like not dropping yet, but almost. You feel me? So they got on the song at the ass end of the song.
So when you end up signing to Warner, is that what led to like the bigger features, the remix with Quavo and Gucci Mane?
We could have did it. We paid for that at our pocket. And like, be honest, we got a deal. Like, we gave both of them a 20 a piece. And right in time, I think them niggas won like 60 or something like that. And they did it for me. Like, out of love, you feel me?
Dang, that's dope. So with signing to Warner, like, what did they really end up providing you? As an artist?
I mean, they really, like, open up doors that we probably couldn't open, you feel me, on our own. But other than that, not too much. Like, it was kind of like, I kind of feel like it was a setback. Like, it was like me starting all the way over again, like, from scratch once I got with the label. That's exactly how it feel to me, though. Once you sign with the label, like, you're starting up from scratch. You're like, okay. Now what y'all gonna do, you feel me? Like, okay, you got me over here. You promised me all this. You feel me? Now what you gonna do?
Because what a lot of people don't understand, when you get signed to a label, it's a tier. Exactly. They got artists that's...
Other artists that's making the money already, bringing income in already. So it's like, you had to wait. You be on like a waiting list type shit. Like, I don't got time to wait.
Yeah. So you, that end up leading you to leave that situation?
Yeah, I ended up getting out that situation. It was like, it was crazy. And I was happy to get out of that situation because I was like, damn, what can I do next? Because it was like, I had a next single, but it was like, they wasn't wanting fun, nothing. So it was like, my management come to me like, no, you got to take this much out of your pocket and spend it. I'm like, man, I should have to spend that much money if I'm signed to a label. Like, why I got to come out of my pocket spending that money? Like, hell no, I ain't doing that. I'm like, so I ended up getting talk to my lawyer or whatever, and however, we got the situation situated. We got it situated, though. And I got out of that situation.
Man, so now you're a free agent.
Free agent.
So what is it like being an independent artist again after being signed? Is it somewhat still the same? Or is it just like you got to go harder? With having that hit single and being on the radio, is it sometimes hard to get that next big hit too?
Yeah, because it'd be like, people want what they want. They like what they like. And once like I dropped that, this is what they expecting from me. Not knowing it was just a song I really did, just having fun. But this not really me. And it was like, I was caught up in making music that everybody else wanted. And I was in one of these little stages where I was like, fuck this shit, man. I ain't doing this shit. So I had to get back in the mode again, like, and tell myself, like, bro, you gotta make the music that you love to make. Like, fuck that. Make the music that make you happy. You feel me?
Word.